I chose to write about the film industry for two reasons. One is that my first job was working for Screen International, which was a cinema trade paper covering the industry, not the commercial side. And so we used to go to Festival de Cannes every year and to MIFED, which is a film market in Milan, but we would work in Nice to cover that for our magazine. So I knew a lot about that side of the industry, the exploitation side, not the glamorous side. And the other reason is that I grew up with horror movies. My generation, we were the first people to have home cinema, VCRs at home. So we just watched horror movies. But our government had a moral panic about the horror movies and they wanted to ban them. And they did create a list of banned titles. So of course, when we were kids, those were the titles we wanted to see. So I wanted to write about the subculture around those movies because they were forbidden. And also because I think the exploitation cinema, horror and all trash cinema always has to be more inventive because they have no money. And so I wanted to write about that culture of trash cinema. I think I always try and find a vehicle for my passions, because it's easier to write a book about something that you really, really love. So that was the real reason. I like horror movies, I like exploitation cinema, and I wanted to write about my experience of Cannes in the 90s. I don't think there's enough women over a certain age in crime fiction. You know, if there's a woman who's over 70 in crime fiction, she is usually the victim, or she is a wise old lady who is, you know, on the side of the story. I wanted it to be about someone who believes that maybe the best years of her life are over, but she rediscovers her joy of life, because Millicent has spent 25 years in prison and she can't adjust to life outside prison and she wants to die. And then she and Jerry, an unlikely pairing, he's an 18-year-old film student, the two of them end up having to share a house together, and they investigate the mystery behind the murder that had her sent to prison. And I wanted that a dynamic of these two very different generations, people from very different backgrounds, but they discover they have a lot in common. They have a love of film in common, but also they've both been outsiders for different reasons. But mostly I wanted to write about Millicent. Mostly I wanted to write about someone who's got a point of view that isn't represented enough in popular crime fiction. You know, apart from Miss Marple and Agatha Christie, I've always put a lot of humour in my work. People use the term noir for crime fiction, and I don't think what I write is very noir. I like there to be a lot of humour, and the best humour comes from the darkest situations. My first 10 or 12 books were almost comic novels. They were very satirical. And I've always brought a kind of social satire to my work. So if I find something absurd, I can't resist putting in the jokes. My wife and I write together under the name Ambrose Parry, and I'm always putting in very bad jokes. And she says we can't have that joke, but she knows that once I've decided if the joke is terrible, I'm going to insist that it goes in. But it's just because I think life isn't, even in the darkest of times, life isn't always bleak. There's always humour. I think there's something unrealistic if you're reading a book or watching a movie or a TV show and it's so serious, nobody ever cracks a joke. Real life is not like that.